Hi everyone, my name is Susan Mingle. I'm a clinical specialist educator for MedOne Group. I'm happy to be here today, and my purpose today is to show you the Alaris point of care unit and the PCA module that you've recently acquired for use. I'd like to start out the presentation with an overview of what we call the point of care unit, or PCU. A lot of nurses like to call this the brain, because without this, nothing works. So let me just go through some of the features of the PCU before we get started with the PCA part. The PCU is designed much like an ATM interface. You see arrow keys that surround the screen. You have a very large color screen. You have your silence button and your options, and then you have your system on. And just below is your numeric keypad. Notice that the decimal is highlighted with a red circle. On the sides of the PCU are what we call IUI connectors. This is where the modules of the Alaris system will attach and reattach at 45 degree angles, up to a maximum of 4. And if you'll notice, on the back of the PCU is where your power cord is. This will power up to 4 devices with only the one plug. You do have a black button here. If you press that and hold it, it will lock out the keypad so that patients and or family members will not be able to access the panel on either the PCU or any of the modules. There's also a ABGN card, which is your wireless card, should that be connected to the network once these devices are brought into the organization. Lastly, the battery is located beneath the PCU, and for biomed, it's a very easy release and pop out and a replacement if necessary. This is the IUI connector that I previously discussed. This is where the PCU is able to communicate with any of the Alaris modules. In this case, I will be attaching the PCA module. Hold the PCA by the handle, raise it to a 45 degree angle, insert it into the IUI connector, and then click it into place. You should hear the click, knowing that you've got connectivity established. So the PCA module, if you noticed, was placed on the right-hand side of the PCU. We'll talk about that in just a second. Some things I would like you to notice on each of the modules. You have a channel select, a pause, a channel off, and a restart button. A few things are done on the PCA module itself, but the majority of the programming is going to be done on the PCU. This is where the key is inserted so that you can have access to opening the acrylic door. But I also want you to notice why it's on the right-hand side is that, if you'll see here, I added a large volume pump to demonstrate this visually. You have to press the blue button to remove the module. With the PCA, notice there's no blue button. You actually have to have a key to gain access to be able to open up the door, thereby pushing this latch, and then you can remove the module. You do have multiple options for the tubing for the PCA syringes. For our purposes today, I'm going to be using what we refer to as a pigtail set, so I'm able to Y in my carrier fluids when I start my PCA. The PCA will accept any 20 to 60 ml syringe, BD, Monoject, Terumo, IMS, Pharmedium, any of those syringes. And the good news about that is that if there's a plant shutdown or a back order on any of the glass vials that you may currently use, pharmacy is able to compound these and make them themselves. Tubing wise, I'm using a pigtail set, but there's multiple choices that you could use in your facility. That would be up to you and your pharmacy and nursing to decide. Prior to starting this, we want to go ahead and prime our tubing. And in this pigtail set, you just want to make sure you've primed your tubing and then Y your carrier fluids through, and then attach it at the IV insertion site. And then we always recommend going ahead and clamping it off prior to starting it. You have to have a key, or you can use a code to access the door. Most hospitals use a key. So we're going to place our key in, and we're going to turn it to unlock, and we're going to open the door. And this is a three-step load. You're going to have claws at the top. Place your flanges underneath this gray area, and if you'll notice this little black button, that's actually a sensor. And it determines the internal diameter of each of the manufacturer's syringes, because they're all different. And it's important to note that once we start choosing our syringe size. Then we're going to pull out this barrel clamp and move it away. So now I'm going to load it. 1, 2, and 3. Then we're going to close the door, and we're going to go ahead and lock it back. And now we're ready to turn it on and start our infusion. So before we turn it on, just so you know, your hospital's pharmacy has loaded PCA drugs to each profile that they've chosen. A profile is simply a care area or a type of patient you're taking care of. For example, med-surg, critical care, or pediatrics, oncology, just depending on what your hospital has chosen. And each of those profiles have minimum and maximum rates and weights. And also, the drugs that they've chosen have what we call our guardrails limits, so that if you make a programming error or miss a decimal, the guardrails will give you a prompt, a screen that says, are you sure you want to do this, because you're outside hospital's best practice. That's also what's known as a smart pump, and this is a smart PCA pump. So now we're ready to start an infusion. I'm going to go ahead and reach out to the system on key and turn it on. And you'll notice some lights that are going to light up here on the PCA, just meaning that the connectivity between the PCU and the PCA is intact. The first clinical question it's going to ask you, is this a new patient? Remember the arrow keys that correspond the screen. You're just looking for the answer that you're looking for. And in this case, is this a new patient? I'm going to say yes, that's what I want. And it'll default to the last profile that it was used in, which is med-surg, and that is what I want for this scenario. Now it's going to be in just a calm, quiet mode until I'm ready to go ahead and activate the PCA. So backing up to the initial turn-on, if it's not a new patient, you would say no. If you're not working in med-surg, then you would have said no and gone back to your hospital's customized list of profile areas and choose the one that you want. What that does is, like, I'm in med-surg right now. That means the list of drugs for PCA in med-surg are available for me to use. They could be different. Let's say if I were in pediatric using a PCA, they would have smaller max and minimum rates and weights. So it's always good to make sure that the profile that it defaults last to is the one that you want to go ahead and move forward with. If not, just say no. And again, you'll see your hospital's customized list of those profiles. So now I'm ready to go. We have our tubing primed and loaded. I'm going to keep it clamped until I'm ready to hook it to the patient. So I'm going to go ahead and hit channel select. It's telling me I need to turn my key to program. Confirm that that's the correct time of day. Obviously, if it's not, you would change the time. It's going to recognize a syringe. Notice there wasn't anything there, so I hit all syringes. Now it recognizes that there's a BD 5060, and that's what I'm going to choose, and I'm going to press confirm. And then here's my list of drugs that your pharmacy has loaded in based on your formulary. And in this demonstration, I'm going to choose morphine. Notice there's two choices, acute and chronic. I'm going to choose acute, and I'm just going to choose the one-to-one. Is this correct? Yes. This is a clinical advisory, just a post-it note to nurses to follow a practice or a protocol. You confirm it. I'm going to confirm past this next screen because the PCA with the PAUSE protocol, the entitle module, is not going to be part of this. If it's something you're interested in, you should see your Med1 rep for more information. So now I'm just going to verify one-to-one. I'm going to confirm that. And now here's my infusion modes, which are your multiple ways to infuse your PCA meds. I'm going to choose PCA dose plus continuous. And this is pre-populated based on physician orders. If this were not, you would be able to program each one of these steps to follow a doctor's order. Now it's telling me to close and lock the door. And now I can press start. And now I will take the key out. And next we're going to talk about the dose request cord or the patient request cord. So now we have started our infusion and I'm holding the dose request cord or patient request cord. I have it in a profile called 1, and there are three profiles available. Profile 1 is by far the most popular and preferred on our PCA module. When a dose is available, the light is on. So I do have a dose available. So I'll press the button. You'll hear a beep. You'll also read that it's delivering that bolus dose. And then also the light is flashing when I'm getting my additional dose. Once the dose has been given, this light will stop blinking and go into what we call our lockout mode, which is for 10 minutes. So when you're instructing to your patient about when these are available and when they're in the lockout, it really helps them to understand that they're getting it and that they're in a 10-minute lockout as long as this light is off. So once this is done, now you'll see it is flipped back over to my continuous dose of one, and that was completed, and now my light is off. Profile two, the light is on all the time, whether one's available, whether they're receiving it, or whether they're in their lockout. Profile three, just the opposite, it's off all the time. So I guess you guys could see it's probably better to use profile one just from a patient compliance standpoint so they won't be pressing the button all the time. So I'm gonna go ahead and press it another time, and you see nothing happens. And then I'm gonna press it one more time, and you see nothing happens. So I think it'll really cut down on the numbers of attempts that a patient will make when they really understand that when a light is on, then there are extra medications available. So now we're going to look at patient history. How many delivers, how many demands, just an overall detail of what's been going on to the patient since the PCA started. So this you're gonna do with a channel select, and then go over here to our options button, which is below the silence button. Now you're gonna see the PCA patient pause limits, infusion modes, patient history, and that's what you wanna see. If you wanna look at those three setups here, the dose record that we spoke about, that's a good place to look at there. But here we're gonna go to patient history. Now this will default to 8 hours of history. If you want earlier history, 1, 2, 4 hours, whatever, you just press this zoom button to zoom in to that section of time that you wanna specifically look at. Now this is a 24 rolling total. Keep that in mind. So your total drug, the number of demands, and the ones that were delivered. And see, I pushed on the button twice after we got this thing started. So that's where you'll see all the information that you need. If you need more of a detail, press the detail button. Then you can see exactly the total drug, the dose, the continuous versus that loading or any bolus doses that you've given, and an average of drug per hour if that detail is needed. So again, to get out of this, you press exit, and you don't really have to restart it. It's still continuing to infuse while you're looking at all that history, but you just want to start to get out of that screen and back to the main screen. So now my patient is complaining of having breakthrough pain that's not being resolved by the dose that he's on. So I have a physician order to give a bolus dose, and I'll show you how you do that. Of course, you're going to have your key, channel select. I want to give a bolus dose. I set my key to program. And I'm also going to show you how the guardrail safety software works should I make a decimal error or key press error. I'm going to think that I'm hitting 2.5, but I'm accidentally going to hit 25. So this is an example of where pharmacy can set a hard stop, meaning I can't do anything except reprogram the pump. Nothing past 3. Now I'm going to go back and put in 2 and make sure I hit that decimal, 0.5, and press confirm. Now this is what we call a soft limit because it's asking me, do you want to proceed, yes or no? I have a physician order, my patient condition is warranting it, so I'm going to say yes, and I'm going to override that and press start. It's not a bad thing if I have a physician order and my patient's condition is warranting it. Just so you know, this is the smart PCA we talked about, and you can have hard stops and soft limits so that the soft limits can be overridden. And notice the G right here. This just means I'm in a guardrail alert, and if you press that, you can see what the guardrail alert is and what the guardrail limit was of 2, and I overrode that by 0.5 milligram. So now you can see that we're delivering this bolus dose, and it's scrolling across saying that it's a bolus dose, and the green light is infusing, meaning that the dose is going. Once the dose is complete, then it's going to flip back automatically to the base rate that we had of that 1 milligram. And you'll be able to also see that reflected in your patient history. Under the bolus dose, you look under the patient detail, and you'll be able to see how much was given and at what time it was given. So during the delivering of our bolus, we received what's called a near end of infusion alert. Notice it's still green, but it's beeping an amber color to let you know that you need to go get your next syringe. So you can press the silence button and go retrieve your syringe. This is going to continue to beep just like a near end KVO on a large volume infusion until you come back with your subsequent syringe. If you don't come back in time, the syringe will go to a syringe empty alarm, meaning that it's empty and it will stop infusing. I'm going to also simulate that syringe empty for you so you can see what that looks like as well. So this is what happens after the near end of infusion alert. If you haven't come in to change your syringe, it'll go to the syringe empty alarm and it will stop infusing because there's no green light. So I'm going to silence this. And I'm going to go ahead and show you how you would change a syringe out. And let's say you're coming back in with the same volume, the same drug, the same parameters. You're going to reload your syringe, the three steps. And close and lock the door. Hit channel select. And turn your key to program and look for your syringe. You confirm your syringe size and notice this restore button. If everything is the same and you're swapping out a syringe that was the exact same as the one prior, you press restore and all those parameters will populate for you so you don't have to put everything back in again. It'll pre-populate the same thing and you're ready to start back over by pressing start. So now your patient has been given discharge orders and you're ready to turn the PCA device off. First thing you need to do is make sure you check your history so you can document that prior to discontinuing. Remember, channel select, options, patient history. Then you'll have a total of all the history of that patient so that you can chart it prior to discontinuing the device. So you can exit out of there once it's done. And then simply on the PCA module itself, one of those buttons we talked about is channel off. Go ahead and press and hold till you hear a little chirp. Let go. And now you've powered down your PCA. Thank you very much.